the boomstick, the railgun, the zoom bank, the $5,000 decoy. Whatever you call your op, there's no denying the terrifying presence it can have in the right hands. But being an opper requires a different skill set from any other gun. So how do you make sure the cost doesn't go to waste? What's up, Pro Guides fam? I'm Boggs, and today we're going over 6 tips every opper must know. Whether you want to switch things up with an op mid-game, or plan on becoming a dedicated opper for your team, these tips are guaranteed to help you succeed with the big green gun. Before we get into the video though, it's time for our question of the day, which is, who is your favorite opper? I'm a huge Simple fan, going back to his days on Liquid in North America, and then of course in his tenure on Na'Vi, where he's solidified himself as one of the best players of all time. His insanely aggressive playstyle, his nutty plays that come out of nowhere, all phenomenal. But maybe you're a fan of Device with his cool and calculated movement, Fallen, Op and IGL, or even maybe somebody like Uzi, an up-and-comer from North America. I'd love to hear who your favorite oppers are, so let us know down in the comments below.
Real quick, I just want to let you all know that we have a 25% off discount going on the website right now. All you got to do is go in, check out, and enter code FPS25 to get that 25% off discount.
But without further ado, let's get into our first tip of the day. Plan your buy ahead of time. Before you ever even pick up an op, you'll need to decide whether your team needs one. If you're having success playing faster paced, you can probably stick to rifles, since having an op will lower the amount of players able to take fights together. An opper specializes in picking off enemies across the map, countering the enemy's ops, and holding angles for their teammates. If you're better off rushing B, don't leave your teammates down a player unless you know you can support them with utility or a first pick before you explode onto site. If the enemy team is on an eco, you also shouldn't pick up an op, since you can't hold multiple enemies swinging at once unless you're in the perfect position. If they are on an eco, there's a decent chance you'll be caught off guard and inadvertently give the enemy a much better chance of winning the round. Hold off until you know they have rifles and potentially an opper too. Besides, the best oppers in the game are just as competent with rifles as they are with ops, and they don't need to have one every round to be successful. But if you have decided now is the best time to buy an op, then it's time to move on to our next tip. Look for patterns in your enemy's playstyles. Specifically, you're looking for a weakness and how you can exploit them for kills throughout the round. For example, say you're defaulting on A ramp Mirage, and you find a player that's running past bench to connector from CT spawn at the start of every round. If you've got a good ramp spawn, you can go for the pick and potentially have a man advantage within the first 20 seconds of the round. Building off of that information, maybe the player is running to connector and peeking mid each round. After picking him off from ramp, he decided to go hold his peek from top mid the next round, catching the kill before he even has a chance to react. After toying with a connector player for a few rounds, you might decide to go hold for a jump spot or an overly aggressive rifler at van on B. Keeping tabs on the patterns your enemies fall into round after round will help you find kills and get the man advantage for your team consistently. But these early picks aren't the only way you can exploit your opponent. You can look for weak utility that your opponents are constantly throwing, such as smokes with gaps or molotovs that don't actually stop you from peeking. Any little mistake your opponents make can provide you with a free kill if you can spot their weaknesses. For more tips on adjusting mid-round and how to outplay your opponents, consider checking out Fallen's course at our website proguides.com. Fallen explains how to outplay your opponents by utilizing positioning to your advantage, among a variety of other pro-level tips. Whether you're just starting out or plan on exclusively opping, Fallen's course will teach you how to think like a pro. Another thing to keep in mind is that if you're looking for patterns in your enemy's plays, chances are they're also looking for patterns in your own play. This brings us to our third tip, play dynamically. Think about the patterns you're showing to the enemy team, whether it be going for picks aggressively every round or holding down a certain side constantly. If the enemy knows what to expect, they'll start to adjust based on what is and isn't working for them. This means the picks you may have found easily early on won't work as well later in the half, and you might even get fully countered if you consistently go for the same picks. Picking Banana on Inferno, for example, can be a great way to catch the enemy off guard, but constantly going there is just asking for the enemy to start throwing Molotovs and HE grenades at you. Instead, consider moving around the map, picking up spots that your teammates might not be holding as well with a rifle, or in places that the enemy wouldn't expect you to go to. Even if you found success at opping Banana early on, consider going for a peek on mid if you have a good spawn, or holding apartments for an early kill. After you've got that opening pick, think about where you can find your next kill. If you just got a pick in mid as a CT on Mirage, consider rotating to Ticket Booth for your next kill. or holding B apartments for market so your riflers can focus on catwalk. You also need to consider which rounds are the best to play aggressive versus passive. If you're not finding as much success going for the early kills as CT, consider holding down apartments from the start or opting ticket booth instead. Locking down the early aggression from the enemy team can be just as big a relief for your teammates as finding an opening pick. Playing dynamically is especially important on T-side, since finding the opening pick can greatly improve your team's chances of winning the round. Look at the spawn you have and decide whether you have a good spawn for an early pick, or if you should instead support your riflers with utility early on before getting aggressive later. As a final note, even though you should focus on being unpredictable, this doesn't mean you should give up an angle early on. If you have control over an aggressive angle, don't give it up after a few seconds just because you haven't seen anyone. Once you fall off that angle, it's pretty risky to get back. Moving on, let's talk about tip number 4, which is using your utility to your advantage. As an AWPer, utility will make your job a whole lot easier. Flashing off common spots an enemy AWPer might be holding will allow you to post up for their re-peek, giving you the advantage in the fight. You can also ask your teammates to flash for your peek as you would with a rifle, allowing you to then just post up on the new angle for a free kill. If you've been playing a bit aggressively and just got a kill, tossing a flash as you leave or having a teammate flash for you to re-peek can mean the difference between life and death. Molotovs can help you clear out spots, and having a teammate throw them while you hold will let you easily kill any player you're trying to get out. If you're holding Arch or Porch on Inferno as a terrorist, you can have a teammate molly cubby or under balcony while you post up, catching the player falling back. In general, try to have your teammates throw molotovs or flashes for you, since pulling out your gun after tossing a nade will take longer than already having your scope up and ready to go. If you're holding a spot on your own, smokes can also be incredibly helpful. Finding a few one-way smokes can help you get free picks around the map, and using gaps in your enemy's smokes will allow you to pick players unexpectedly. Just remember to watch out for a few bullets in your direction after you've shot, since the opponents will have a decent idea of where you're at. Our fifth tip of the day is about peeking, because how else are you going to kill your opponents? With an AWP, utilize a variety of peeks based on each situation, again making yourself as unpredictable as possible. Baiting out an enemy AWPer's shot by swinging just your shoulder around a corner can allow you to get on the angle they were holding. If they re-peek you, all you have to do is click, and you'll have the kill. When peeking around a corner, consider swinging without crouching, since you'll show less of your body than a crouch peek would. This isn't to say you shouldn't ever crouch, though. Crouch peeking does allow you to be completely accurate while moving, so you can employ some crouch peeking if you need to move to a safer spot while holding down an angle. You should think about the difference between crouch peeks and standing peeks as a difference in speed, essentially. If you need to peek something quickly, it is best to swing out while standing and quickly counter-strafe once it's time to shoot. This works best when you know exactly where the enemy is playing from. If you need to work a few angles more methodically, crouch peeking while slowly clearing out each angle might be better. You should also crouch if it'll help you shield more of your body from the enemy. Ideally, you should only be showing your head or a small portion of your body with each angle you hold. You should try to make yourself as hard of a shot as possible, while still having a strong angle on the opponent. Finally, if you're pinned down, consider using a jiggle peek to find out where to pre-aim on your next peek. If you're opting from a spot like New Box on Inferno or Triple Box on Mirage, jiggle peeking to find out where your enemies are before swinging out again with a pre-aim on them will help you get quick, instant kills, better than crouching around and looking for each player. These jiggle peeks should be just wide and just quick enough so that you can see the enemy, but not enough for them to have an easy shot back onto you. Our final tip might not be exclusive to AWPers, but definitely applies to anyone still learning how to AWP. Don't fall into bad habits. Just because something worked for you once or twice does not mean it's necessarily a good thing. Quick switching, for example, might look cool and provide you with a bit of extra information at times, but will slow you down if you need to re-peek or kill a second player swinging into you. Constantly quick switching means you'll have to scope in again and reset where you're looking, which can slow you down in close quarters fights. This isn't to say that quick switching is any faster or slower than waiting for the AWP to scope back in. It's about the same speed if you do, but having to right-click again immediately while being rushed can be a costly trade-off. Another common mistake is going for overly aggressive fights you can't fall back from. No matter what pick you're going for, you should have an escape route in mind in case the enemies try to rush you down. Jumping out mid-window on Mirage, for example, might catch your opponents off guard, but will also leave you stranded if you have no one to help you back to safety. Also, try not to hold too tight of angles while opping. No one has the reaction time you'd need to be able to shoot immediately at somebody swinging around a corner. Except for maybe Simple, you'll almost always have to flick a bit, making you less accurate. So instead, hold where you know your enemy will be peeking, giving yourself at least a few pixels of a lead. While you might find some success against worse players with these habits, better players will be able to punish you easily. Keep in mind whether a play you're making or a habit you're falling into is objectively the right play. A good rule of thumb is whether you see good players doing what you're doing. If a pro won't hold an angle the way you hold it, maybe you're not playing that position the best way you can. To sum things up, the op is an incredibly diverse weapon with a skill set unlike any other in the game. In the right hands, it's also the most powerful weapon, so using it right can be a game changer. Before buying the op, make sure it's the right time to buy one. If your enemies are on eco or are weak enough against rifles, you might opt to stick with an AK or an M4 instead. Once you pick an op, make sure to play dynamically and unpredictably, capitalizing on any patterns your enemies fall into. Have your teammates support you with utility throughout the round, and use your own for picks or to ensure your safety. Keep an eye on any bad habits you might be forming, whether you're winning and losing. If you want some individualized tips on how to bring your opting to the next level, come talk to a coach on our website at ProGuides.com. Our coaches can help you figure out any mistakes you might not be aware of, and will help you become a force to be reckoned with. Well, that's all we have for you today, ProGuides fam. If you learned something today, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, and ring that notification bell to make sure you stay up to date with all our videos. Let us know your favorite opera in the comments down below, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace out.